But I know that you've got your reasons. These things that are pleasing you can hurt you.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and now 102.3 FM.
1050 AM. Don't forget that number. And for you young people who got here by accidentally fat-fingering your FM band selector, we're an AM radio station, and AM refers to more than just the time of day.
I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from fabulous Las Vegas. Today's show is brought to you by Legal Shield, providing legal protection and peace of mind. Legal Shield can help with traffic tickets, texting and driving, DUIs, court appearances, estate planning, even contracts given to people they don't understand, plus a whole lot more. For more information, contact Legal Shield at 213-245-1305. That's 213-245-1305. Or visit them online for more information at nocourt.us. That's nocourt.us. Big round of applause for Legal Shield.
Yes.
All right, and joined by two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, Tyrone Poole. Tyrone, of course, over our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast. You're always looking good. Look, he's got that top button. He's always got the big smile. Got those big, shiny Super Bowl trophies behind him, too.
How you doing, Sal? Hello to everyone that is watching and listening. Welcome to another exciting moment of the Sports Circus. So I hope you got your popcorn. If you're still in line waiting to get your popcorn, you better hurry up and come sit down because you're about to miss a great opening. Back to the ringmaster himself, Sal.
A great opening, he says. That's okay. All right. Guess what? Tyrone, right from the very top, we have a very special guest. And you know what? I think I'm just going to let him introduce himself. What do you think? Is that a good idea? Let's do
it. Yeah, it's an awesome idea.
All right. There he is.
Hey, guys. How are you? Thanks for having me on. I'll introduce myself. I'm Mike Crawford, President and CEO of the Hall of Fame Resort and Entertainment Company. Great to be here with you today. Under the big top.
Very exciting. That's very exciting. That's over in Canton, Ohio at the Pro Football Hall of Fame. Wow, very exciting.
Yeah, exactly. We're here in Canton. The weather's starting to break a little bit. Pro Football Hall of Fame, we're the greatest ever play the game. I think Tyrone should probably be here as well. Two-time Super Bowl champ, my gosh. But a lot of exciting things here in Canton and outside of Canton with the company as well. So looking forward to talking to you today.
Tyrone, it's coming. Tyrone, yeah. And in fact, Tyrone was just inducted, if I'm not mistaken, for the College Football Hall of Fame just recently. So, Tyrone, maybe you'll be getting that knock on the door from Mr. Baker saying, Tyrone, guess what? We've got a gold jacket for you. What do you think about that one?
Yeah, I know that would be awesome. But also those who are listening would love this. When Carolina and the Jacksonville Jaguars inaugural season, we played our first game, the preseason game, just kicked the 95 season off in Canton. So I got footage of me picking off the Jacksonville Jaguars, taking it in for a touchdown. So I think I scored the first defensive touchdown for the Carolina Panthers in our preseason game. So awesome. Canton, Ohio. Yes.
Very exciting. It's very exciting. And, you know, by the way, a big welcome to everybody also watching in 650,000 rooms across these United States of America and every metered market in hotels, upscale hotels. Tell you what, folks, that's 4.8 million impressions per hour. That's a lot of people that get to see what we're doing right here. And we've got a two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior. And we also have the top guy over at the Hall of Fame Village and Entertainment Company, Mike Crawford, President, CEO, Tank Commander. What does it take to be the Tank Commander of the organization?
You got to be a little goofy. You got to have a little bit of a vision. You got to be able to lead, I guess. Tyrone should know a little bit about that. Not the goofy part, but the being able to lead. Look, you got to have a passion for what you do, just like anything else. If you're going to be successful, you have to have a passion for what you do. You have to have a team around you that is really great at what they do. And you have to have a game plan. And when you have those things, it makes it a lot easier to execute for somebody like me.
Tyrone, you know something about execution and game plans, don't you?
You know, Mike hit it right on the head. You know, I call it the finish line. And I like to use the 4x1 as an example. Finish line means there's a goal. And like Mike said, with the Hall of Fame, you know, what he's doing there and helping that be seen by a lot of fans and people coming in, even those who don't know anything about football. But the finish line, I like to use it because that is the goal. That is what we're trying to achieve. That is the ultimate end of the year party. So I use track and field 4x1. You got four individuals trying to come together as a team to get that baton to the finish line. So it takes different guys with different or women from different backgrounds, different abilities. Some can run the curve better. Some can run the straight better. Some are great finishers. So it's all about organization, putting them in the right position so you can get that baton across and turn around and say, hey, we did it. We did it. We reached our goal. We crossed the finish line. So, yes.
I like that. So, hey, listen, Mike, let me ask you a question about the organization itself. I mean, the differences, the different business lines within the organization. Could you talk a little bit more about that?
Yeah, sure. I'll tell you, you know, we're the only company really that's based on the power of professional football today. We're publicly traded. We're on the NASDAQ. And when we built the strategy, I joined here, you know, after a lot of years with the Walt Disney Company, some years with the Four Seasons Hotel and Resort Group as well. And when I joined in December of 18, one of the things that I quickly saw was the ability to create great content. You have the most popular sport in America, professional football, 185 million fans worldwide watching this sport, cheering their heroes, cheering their teams, living in the cities, and really enjoying the game. And it was pretty obvious to me that we had a chance to create experiences that no other company could do. So we built a company that has three business verticals. The first is creating themed destination-based assets. Here in Canton, Ohio, that's what our focus has been. We've built phase one. We've spent about $300 million in creating new assets. We've opened a new hotel. We're building a brand new integrated facility where you can come and shop and play and be entertained. You can stay. Eventually, you'd be able to live. So a live, work, play type of environment is what we're looking at here. But we're also focused on creating destination assets, maybe not to this scale, but in other NFL franchise cities as well. And if you think about what we have, you have the NFL Pro Football Hall of Fame. You have a great way in which you can create content out of those assets that are already in place. We have a world-class football stadium in our Tom Benson Hall of Fame stadium. We have a National Youth Football and Sports Complex. So we're already driving great programming and event content here in Canton today. But beyond that, the second sort of vertical we have is media. And as I was talking about the Pro Football Hall of Fame and those that are enshrined in the Hall of Fame, you know, we have a lot of content in there that hasn't been used to tell those stories. And recently we've made some announcements with some of the Hall of Famers that have also won Heisman trophies. Heisman to Hall is the group, and Elite Holdings is the company. You know, 10 guys have won a Heisman trophy and also gone on to be enshrined in the Pro Football Hall of Fame. More people have walked on the moon, right? So that's a story that has to be told. There's a lot of professional football athletes in communities doing great things for their communities. Inspired is another story that we're creating with our partner at Tupelo Honey. We brought the NFL Alumni Developmental Academy here in Canton, Ohio. This is an academy just for those kids who almost made their dreams come true but didn't quite make an NFL team. So we have them here. They're being trained by former NFL head coaches, Hall of Famers, player position coaches. And in the meantime, we said, gosh, you know, this is a real live story. People want to know how these kids are doing. So we're developing a docuseries with partners from Sports Illustrated and Studio 101. Think Last Chance U, you know, Hard Knocks, that kind of docuseries. But media is a big way in which fans engage with sport and professional football in general. So we felt like we had access, direct access to exclusive content out of our Hall of Fame and with our Hall of Famers and others that we could build content off of. And we're already doing that. And then, of course, last but not least, gaming. You know, esports has taken off. There's been no good that's come out of this health pandemic. But I will tell you what it has done is propel virtual experiences, right? So fantasy sports has always been, these are multi-billion dollar industries. And what we've done is create experiences within those verticals that we think are unique and different. So this year we're launching our Hall of Fantasy League. It'll be the first fantasy league of its kind, franchise-based. Think about NFL teams. So we haven't announced yet, but we will. The cities where these franchises will be, they'll have front offices. We announced a partnership with a company called Stake Kings, and it allows fans to put a stake into a team, almost like an ownership stake, and really cheer for the team and be a part of a community just like a city could for Cleveland Browns, you know, or the Pittsburgh Steelers. That's the same sort of concept we're creating in fantasy. Nothing like it. Great opportunity for a unique gaming experience for our fans that are already wanting to play fantasy, but how or don't have time. And then lastly, sports betting, right? You know, when those teams can play each other virtually because they're franchise teams, people enjoy placing a bet on the games. And we think we have an opportunity to create that kind of environment for our guests as well. And so sports betting, while not legal yet in Ohio, is something that I'm focused on as an opportunity for our company, because it really does enhance the way in which guests engage and fans engage with whatever sport that they're watching. And it's no longer that ugly thing as you set out in Las Vegas.
I know.
You're not going to your bookie down the alleyway. You actually have a chance to make a bet and enjoy it. So those are our three business verticals.
Okay, well, folks, we're going to be back here with Mike Crawford, president and CEO of the Hall of Fame Village and Entertainment Company at Canton, Ohio, and two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, Tyrone Poole. Don't go anywhere, folks. Lots more to come here on The Circus.
Has someone in your family lost a job recently and now you can't afford your mortgage payment? Or do you have a rental property and your tenants aren't paying you? Quick Cash Offer can come to the rescue and pay you cash for your home immediately. Yes, sell your home and get cash all over the phone without dealing with real estate agents and risking your safety by showing your home to lukewarm buyers. You don't need to lose your home to foreclosure. If you have any equity in your home, we will buy it and give you cash within days, all in a simple over-the-phone and virtual process. Call Quick Cash Offer now before the economy gets worse. Sell a home you can't afford or just don't want to get the cash you need today.
800-470-7113. 800-470-7113. 800-470-7113. That's 800-470-7113.
AMP, the multi-format network, is here to help create, produce, distribute, and sell your content. For more information, send a message to info@aamp.tv. That's info@aamp.tv.
Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea, the American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com, or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away.
The old way of living with diabetes is a pain. You've got to remember to do your testing, and you always need to be sticking your fingers. The new way to live your life with diabetes is with a continuous glucose monitor. You simply apply a discreet, easy-to-use sensor on your body, and it continuously monitors your glucose levels, helping you spend more time in range and freeing you from painful finger pricks. If you test your blood sugar at least 4 times per day and inject insulin at least 3 times per day, or use an insulin pump and have private insurance, or Medicare, you might be eligible for a CGM with little or no cost to you. Call U.S. Medical Supply today for a free benefits check. We offer free shipping, 90-day supplies, and we bill Medicare or your insurance directly. Call now and say goodbye to finger pricks.
800-854-3183. 800-854-3183. 800-854-3183. That's 800-854-3183.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. My name is Tyrone Poole. This segment is brought to you by the Tyrone Poole 38 Foundation. At the Tyrone Poole 38 Foundation, we believe in reforming, refilling, and restoring ultimate success in everyday people's lives. And if you want to learn more about how we do it, and if you want to donate, go to TyronePoole38Foundation.org. Again, that's TyronePoole38Foundation.org. We want to welcome back all those who are listening and watching, those who are listening to us on CBS, Fox, NBC, Sports Affiliates, watching us in Hotel TV. Hello, hello, how you doing? How you doing? And all of those who are watching us on Facebook streaming at AMP TV. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We have an exciting guest today, Mike Crawford. Talk about the Pro Football Hall of Fame. I should be in the Pro Football Hall of Fame. Mike, you got to vote for me, get me there. But we got a ringmaster, Sal, the man who started the Sports Circus right there. He always comes in on cue. Man, he just like the wind. He just blows in. But welcome, everybody. Turn it over to Sal. We got a great guest, Mike. Sal, have at it, man. Go at it.
Oh, that's good stuff. That's good stuff. And thank you. 2-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, Tyrone Poole. You know, that American Ninja Warrior thing, yeah, that takes an athleticism beyond what most people can imagine. Now, one of my friends happens to be the Cowboy Ninja, and he is one of those American Ninja Warriors, a very popular one. And so Tyrone, going from the NFL to American Ninja Warrior and going that path, it's kind of like, look, asking yourself about the Hall of Fame, do you belong? I would say, look, this is more about a diversified athlete. It's about a champion. It's about a leader on and off the field, but also somebody that could do things that other people can't. And if you could be an American Ninja Warrior, something tells me that you probably may qualify here, at least to have a conversation here with this guy over on the other side, over in Canton, Ohio. What do you think?
Yeah, I know. I'm going to have to call Mike up personally, and we got to get a Zoom session because of the pandemic. But you know me, Mike, I'm the type of person, I get a ticket, I put my mask on, and I fly and knock on your door. Mike, hey, need to talk, man, the Hall of Fame. Come on, Mike, come on.
I think you got that reversed. We're supposed to fly and knock on your door.
Right. Hey, not Tyrone.
I'm trying to get
easy. Well, see, Tyrone was purposely putting his arms up. This is for the TV audience. He was purposely putting his arms up and trying to strong arm somebody into the discussion. I already know what you're up to. Come on, man.
There's a few out there that like to have that discussion, but we'd like to have it with you, Tyrone. That would be great.
That's great stuff. All right. So, hey, listen, Tyrone, in between sessions, by the way, folks, if you don't know who Mike Crawford is, Mike is the chairman, president, and CEO of the Hall of Fame Village and Entertainment Company in Canton, Ohio. Pro Football Hall of Fame, you probably heard of that, right? Well, you've got a village that's being constructed to do all kinds of great things and entertainment for everybody. We talked a little bit about that in the last segment, but we also talked about in between segments about other sports too. And Tyrone, you did mention something. Before we get into the ins and outs of the Hall of Fame Village, beyond what Mike Crawford has given us. I want to get that out there, Tyrone. What were you mentioning in between segments?
But no, what I was mentioning, we went to commercial. You know, I've had the opportunity to be on various shows, and esport, like Mike mentioned, is very, very, like, it's gaining so much momentum. And people have asked me, are esport gamers athletes? And me personally, I think they are virtual athletes. I don't think they're physical athletes because there's so much demand on the body when you're doing something physically. Now, does it take a skill set to be able to do and play a game? Sure. Yes, I believe that. But they are not athletes as far as what my understanding is. So I was asking Mike what was his thoughts, and also would there be a Hall of Fame area in Canton for esport gamers? So are esport athletes, are they athletes, gamers, athletes, and will there be, will we see a Hall of Fame section in Canton for esport gamers?
Well, and what I said on the break was, you know, I want to be careful here because esports is a part of our business and we want to make sure that we're here and serving everybody who likes to play or engage with professional football. But I would tend to agree. It is an athlete in the sense that you have to have great mental toughness. You have to have great hand-eye coordination. You have to have an ability to strategize and put a team on a field and think about plays and you know, optimize your approach against another opponent. So from that perspective, you know, an athlete has all those same types of skills. Now, are they on the field of battle? Are they, you know, engaging in some of that tackle or some of that physical play? Probably not. Does it take mental toughness and some physical toughness to sit in a chair for 8 hours to do something like that? Probably. I'm not sure I could do it, to be honest with you. Would there be a Hall of Fame for something like that? I don't see a reason why not. Honestly, you have now people going to school to become e-gamers, people creating technology around e-gaming. You know, our vision is to give people a place of excellence to come and play. So I can see us having a great arena for championships to be played. I can see us, along with our youth sports program where we run clinics and camps all over the country, I can see that becoming a part of our programming because, you know, as well as I do, those kids like to get on those games and say, how would I do it if I was actually on the field playing? So there's a little bit of that training. And I think you're seeing that in professional sports where now they're starting to gamify some of what they do as part of their strategy. And I think, and prep work. And I think we could be a big part of that. Hall of Fame, why not? You know, let's have a Hall of Fame. This is a Hall of Fame city. Canton, Ohio is a Hall of Fame city. We celebrate excellence here. You know, we could have Madden Hall of Fame. We could do all kinds of things. It would be great.
That's funny. All right, a big welcome back to everybody that's just tuning in. We're here with Mike Crawford, Chairman, President, and CEO of the Hall of Fame Village and Entertainment Company over in Canton, Ohio. Welcome back to everybody watching on hotel television in 650,000 rooms. Thanks for joining us and everybody else on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates. All right, so there will be possibly a Hall of Fame for gamers, which I find it interesting, guys. I got to tell you, me personally, look, I once upon a time I played baseball. I know what it's like to be out on that field. And I have to tell you, if you could drink a beer and do it, it's not a sport. If you could drink a beer and play whatever you're playing at the same time, it's not a sport. See, I say that about bowling. And my mother was on the PBA tour. And guess what? You could hold a mug of beer in one hand, technically, and throw the ball in the other. So I don't think bowling's a sport. It's a skill game just like golf. Technically, you could swing a golf club with one hand. Of course, a million people will disagree with me on this one, but I believe that virtual sports, they're skill games like bowling and golf and tennis. Now, tennis, it takes a lot of skill, but at the end of the day, the team sports, I guess, when we talk about halls of fame, that's one thing, because these other sports, they have halls of fame. But what about the betting aspect? We did talk a little bit about the betting aspect, Mike, in the last segment. Now, we think about betting on esports, betting on this, betting on that. And I know gambling is on the docket over in Ohio. What is the Hall of Fame Village and Entertainment Company's position on gambling in general, in sports and beyond? How it would affect maybe your local economy?
Well, I think most economies get impacted in a very positive way from gambling. You know, I think there is an opportunity to allow fans to enjoy the game in the way in which they are already enjoying it throughout the country in many places where gambling is legalized. Having said that, you know, our plan is pretty simple. We want to have, as guests and fans come to the campus, we want to have a physical presence where they could place a bet on a game or a virtual game if they'd like. I mentioned our Hall of Fantasy League, our own fantasy experience where you have virtual teams now, franchises, if you will, that can play each other. So we want fans to be able to engage on a sports betting platform there. And, you know, as we think about destinations where we could develop offsite, you know, sort of mini replications of memorabilia, sort of museum, food and beverage, gaming, sports betting locations, where if you were in Vegas, you could do something with the Raiders, more towards the Raiders. If you were in Los Angeles, the Rams, et cetera. I do think sports betting for us is going to be a priority. We're already talking with betting partners and trying to assess, you know, what that looks like in terms of a final plan. But I get excited about it. You know, I really do. I think it's become much more broadly accepted, and people really do have, with technology advancements at their fingertips, the opportunity to place a bet on a game. And in some cases, as technology advances, place a bet on a free throw or a field goal right as they're getting ready to happen. And so, why not? You know, our job is to help enhance the experience for guests and give them a place or an opportunity to do the things they like to do when they're engaging with our company. And that's our goal.
You know, what I liked that you said was the idea about expanding, creating more jobs. So you're really driving that local economy, because the Hall of Fame Village is, folks, it's not just something you blink your eye and you're through it. There is a greater plan, and you've got a very interesting leader. We're going to learn a little bit more about Mike Crawford. What makes him unique? What does it take to lead an organization like this, a publicly traded company on top of it? Look, that's a huge undertaking. We're going to learn a little bit more about that when we come back from break here on the Sports Circus with Mike Crawford, Chairman, President, and CEO of the Hall of Fame Village and two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, Tyrone Poole. Back here, folks, in just a few moments with lots more fun stuff to talk about. And you never know where it's going to go. It's live. We're a circus, and we prove it every day. So stay tuned, folks. Don't go anywhere.
Attention business owners, you and your customers are listening to this commercial right now. Face it, every business needs customers, even yours. The Sports Circus is a primetime nationally syndicated program that's carried on ABC, NBC, CNBC, and Westwood One News affiliates, plus CBS, Fox, and NBC Sports affiliates across North America, with coverage from Hawaii to New York. Also, the Sports Circus is available to the 180 million subscribers on iHeartRadio, and the Sports Circus gets about 4 million website visitors per month, which could click through your website and bring sales. The Sports Circus provides great content featuring celebrity guests from sports and entertainment to our audience every weekday, which your company could greatly benefit from by increasing your visibility, foot traffic, eyeballs to your website, and calls from potential customers. Call us right now at 702-799-9935. Again, 702-799-9935, or email us at info@thesportscircus.com. That's info@thesportscircus.com. Drive your sales today by advertising with the Sports Circus.
So, you want to be in show business. Do people tell you that you're really funny, you have a great personality, and you should have your own talk show? Many of us have been told that, but we don't know how to get started. It's easier than you think. Let the pros at Cali Vegas give you a free talent evaluation. Call 949-445-1119 and learn how quickly you can create, produce, and host your very own talk show. Imagine not having to sit in traffic every day, commuting back and forth to the same old boring job. Get started in television or radio today with your free talent evaluation from Cali Vegas. Call 949-445-1119 or visit them online at calivegas.com.
Make your dream come true today and create your new career and learn how to become a television or radio star with the help of Cali Vegas. 949-445-1119. Call now.
Has someone in your family lost a job recently and now you can't afford your mortgage payment? Or do you have a rental property and your tenants aren't paying you? Quick Cash Offer can come to the rescue and pay you cash for your home immediately. Yes, sell your home and get cash all over the phone without dealing with real estate agents and risking your safety by showing your home to lukewarm buyers. You don't need to lose your home to foreclosure. If you have any equity in your home, we will buy it and give you cash within days, all in a simple over-the-phone and virtual process. Call Quick Cash Offer now before the economy gets worse. Sell a home you can't afford or just don't want to get the cash you need today.
800-470-7113. 800-470-7113. 800-470-7113. That's 800-470-7113.
Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from fabulous Las Vegas. This segment is brought to you by Cali Vegas, helping people create and host their very own radio, TV, or multimedia talk show. Cali Vegas can help people from getting out of sitting in hours of traffic every day, commuting back and forth to the same old boring job, and host their very own talk show in their very own home studio. For more information, contact Cali Vegas at 949-445-1119. That's 949-445-1119. Again, 949-445-1119, or check them out online for more information at calivegas.com. That's calivegas.com. And a big welcome back to everybody listening in on Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas and our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, including our friends over in Honolulu on CBS Sports 1500 KHKA over in sunny Southern California, our NBC News, CNBC financial affiliate, KCAA. Thanks for joining us. And, of course, down in South Texas, home of the Houston Astros, Rockets, and Houston Texans. That'd be CBS Sports. Corpus Christi, thanks for joining us. 107.1 The River, Faraday, Louisiana. Jim Bob and the boys over there, and in Auburn, Alabama, home of the Atlanta Braves, WAUD, Atlanta, WDJY, and Boston, WBNW, and a whole bunch of others, and in hotels from coast to coast. We are joined by two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, Tyrone Poole, and Mike Crawford, hey. Chairman, President, CEO of the Hall of Fame Resort and Entertainment Company over there in Canton, Ohio. You may have heard of that Pro Football Hall of Fame thing over there. That's where this guy is with. I'll tell you what, Mike Crawford, thanks for joining us. Tyrone, thanks for coming back. We've got a lot to talk about here. And in the last segment, I wanted to know a little bit more about Mike, but first, Tyrone, you had a gambling question. I want to get that out there first so we can take another step.
Yeah, you know, I am the, what they say, they have books that are called Football for Dummies or Learning How to Walk for Dummies. So I'm the person sports betting for dummies. So I got a question, Mike. Now, we got all kinds of leagues popping up. People would bet on anything. There's a new sports group or team or league called Fan Control Football. It's a new sport league. We've all heard about Johnny Manziel playing in it and, you know, other names. But will that be something that would be considered betting? I know me personally, I wouldn't want to bet on that because it's too many controversial things that could happen, you know. So my question is, what about that league? Do you see that league kind of like being a good betting option for people?
Well, listen, I probably shouldn't comment on if it's a good or a bad betting option. Here's what I'd say. I think if people feel like whatever it is they're watching or engaging with is fair and balanced, there's not a predetermined outcome that somebody else is controlling, there's always a tendency to want to bet on something. I mean, you can remember growing up in your backyard playing horseshoes or whatever it was you're doing. You're always going to place a bet on something, right? And I think it is what we were talking about now, the way in which technology enables that. Instead of sitting at the football game and watching the field goal getting ready to be kicked, and you turn to your buddy or your wife or whoever and say, hey, I'll bet you $5 that he makes that. Now you just look down at your phone and you can quickly make a bet. And I do think that even that kind of league, as long as fans are there and they're engaged and they see an opportunity to place a bet, it just enhances how they engage with the game. It makes it more exciting. It creates an opportunity for a little friendly competition. And at the same time, you could win a little money as well. So I hear what you're saying, Tara. It's hard to predict, but human nature, the tendencies are, if there's something there to bet on, probably I'll bet on it.
You know, Tyrone, what I like about Mike Crawford is that he's honest about it. He's not giving you a political nonsensical answer. He's just being straight up about it and saying, hey, look, I like to bet. Maybe I could win an extra couple bucks. Maybe I could buy myself an extra hot dog or whatever the hell it is. But the fact is, at least he's saying, hey, look, I kind of dig it. And this is kind of what makes him unique. I want to know a little bit more about the unique characteristics of Mike Crawford. I want to know a little bit more about Mike. How have you dealt with the COVID issue and what has happened as a leader in an organization? I mean, look, this is a publicly traded company. How does this affect your day-to-day decisions and even month-to-month decisions? Because at the end of the day, your shareholders want to know what. How does it affect the bottom line? How's it going to affect my investments?
You know, and they have every right to ask that question. And the answer really is we have to deal with it. And when we were faced with this controversy, we were just getting ready to go public, quite honestly. We delayed that by about 3 months just to make sure we had our legs under us and we understood what the equity markets were really going to look like. And then we were fortunate to go public last year in July. But we take very seriously people's faith in us and giving their hard-earned money, or if you're an institutional investor, the analytics that they do around our company. And I think what comes back all the time is they understand what we're trying to do. They understand that we have a unique direct access to professional football that can be translated into story content, media, gaming content, and then certainly these destinations, or the first one being in Canton. And people really want to be in places with other like-minded fans or guests, right? And so while COVID has been incredibly difficult for the entire world, we're no different. What we've been able to do, and I give a lot of credit to our team. Our team has such passion. And you said, what does it take to be in these times? You know, I quiffed a little bit and said a little goofiness. You have to have a sense of humor, and you have to have an ability to create faith and belief in your team. And this team has done some phenomenal things, signing deals and starting construction on buildings and opening new assets and starting to generate revenue out of a company that frankly is still investing in building and growing. So you have the strategy, you have the plan, and then you got to put the right players on the field to execute. And I think we've done that quite well. My job is to help clear the way, to put the game plan there, to be a coach, if you will, to be a support. You know, experience. I've been in this business for over 30 years with some of the biggest brands out there, and taking those brands and diversifying how fans or guests engage with them and expanding what those brands could do. I think we have that same philosophy here. You know, growing through what we have and staying true to who we are. You know, our tagline is honor the past and inspire the future. And so, you know, with us, clearly we've had the Hall of Fame here for well over 50 years and honoring the best football players to ever play the game. But we're engaged with the NFL. We're engaged with the NFL Alumni Association. We just signed a deal with the Women's Football Alliance, which we're incredibly honored to have their championships here in Canton. Our game plan is simple. Build things where people are going to want to come and be entertained and be engaged with sport or non-sport activities. Create great stories and content from stuff that we have access to and get it out there in different ways in which fans are already engaging. And do it differently, you know, and right. You got to have a team to do that, and we do.
Right. Folks, a big welcome back to everybody watching on hotel television, everybody else tuning in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates, here with Mike Crawford, Chairman, President, CEO, Hall of Fame Resort Entertainment Company. Tell you what, it's a real pleasure to have Mike and two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior Tyrone Poole with us. Let me ask you real quick. Now, this is for our audience on listening in on CNBC and over in Boston on Money Matters Radio. So we have a financial audience as well outside of our sports audiences and music audience. But from an investor standpoint, so I trade stocks on a regular basis as well. And of course, my concern is shareholder equity. How do I have our leader protects shareholder equity, right? And so from the plan so far that you have laid out, the things that you have talked about, it shows a great short run and long run protection for the value and some sustained drivers for economic growth throughout Canton. And I like that idea. I really like that because let's face it, it's not just over here in Canton. It's not just a Hall of Fame. There's a heck of a lot more going on over there.
Yeah, no, I think you nailed it, Sal. You have to have a plan that has legs, right? And we have, I like to refer to it as building franchises from the movie business. You have the ability here to create franchises, and our business plan is a very synergistic, integrated business plan. So as you sign a deal with an NFL alumni association to bring their developmental academy here, you don't just do that to have a great place for these kids to be developed by former coaches. You do that so that you can have an impact on their lives going into the NFL. So we become a pipeline for talent, but you do it so that then you can create content, video, image content out of that that can be seen by multiple millions of people and a business plan that includes that. So we have, something happening live here in Canton. You have something happening over in our media division, and then you create gaming opportunities out of that as well. And so, for us, long-term is certainly out there. We have a lot of land here in Canton to develop upon, up to 600 acres. Disneyland in California is 500 acres, just to put that in perspective. The virtual world is growing. It's multi-billions of dollars and growing of industry. Media is trillions of dollars. And I think we're positioning ourselves well in terms of what we're creating across those three verticals to have that kind of growth that will bring meaningful shareholder returns. And we're executing on the plan, which is important.
Well, everyone who's watching and listening, we are here with Mike Crawford. Mike Crawford of the Hall of Fame Resort Entertainment Company. You know what? We are positioning ourselves for the last segment, so you don't want to miss it. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back with more Sports Circus.
AMP, the multi-format network, is here to help create, produce, distribute, and sell your content. For more information, send a message to info@aamp.tv. That's info@aamp.tv.
Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea. The American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com, or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away.
This is an urgent health notice. All residents suffering from back pain, you may qualify for a pain-relieving back brace covered by Medicare. Simply call the Health Alert Hotline now. The Health Alert Hotline is your back brace company. These specialized braces have been thoroughly tested for pain relief. Call us toll-free right now to determine your eligibility. Don't wait. The deadline is fast approaching. The call just takes a few minutes, and we will handle all of the Medicare paperwork. Back braces have helped thousands of people, just like you, get relief from their back pain and return to living their lives to the fullest, enjoying activities they thought they might never be able to experience again. Find out if you're eligible to receive a pain-relieving back brace. Make sure to have your Medicare card ready when you call. Call us right now.
800-223-7902. 800-223-7902. 800-223-7902. That's 800-223-7902.
Attention business owners, you and your customers are listening to this commercial right now. Face it, every business needs customers, even yours. The Sports Circus is a primetime nationally syndicated program that's carried on ABC, NBC, CNBC, and Westwood One News affiliates, plus CBS, Fox, and NBC sports affiliates across North America with coverage from Hawaii to New York. Also, the Sports Circus is available to the 180 million subscribers on iHeartRadio, and the Sports Circus gets about 4 million website visitors per month, which could click through your website and bring sales. The Sports Circus provides great content featuring celebrity guests from sports and entertainment to our audience every weekday, which your company could greatly benefit from by increasing your visibility, foot traffic, eyeballs to your website, and calls from potential customers. Call us right now at 702-799-9935. Again, 702-799-9935, or email us at info@thesportscircus.com. That's info@thesportscircus.com. Drive your sales today by advertising with the Sports Circus.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from fabulous Las Vegas. Folks, make sure you check out thesportscircus.com for our upcoming guests, our prior guests, our podcast, and as well as our partners. You heard from one of those at the beginning of the second segment, which was the Tyrone Pool 38 Foundation. Make sure you check them out on the partners page at thesportscircus.com. Big round of applause for the TP38 Foundation and all of our other partners. Welcome back to everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, as well as hotel television, here with two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior Tyrone Poole, and also Mike Crawford, chairman, president, CEO, Hall of Fame Resort and Entertainment Company over in Canton, Ohio. Thanks for coming back, everybody. And then
thank you, Sam.
We like that. Folks, see, here's the cool thing about this show. The cool thing about this, look, we don't edit anything. We love the fact that mistakes happen. We say what we need to. And if we trip over our tongue, get over it, people. We're real people. We don't fix it in the mix. This is not the podcast that a million other people do. This is aired over radio, television, even at amp.tv as well. So, folks, guess what? Whatever's out there, it's out there, so get over it. All right. Now, in the last segment, I asked you a little bit about the organization. I want to know more about the board of directors, the management. Tell me a little bit more about your experience and how it lends itself to what you're doing right now. How'd you get into this?
I went down to Walt Disney World when I was about 22 years old and had no intention of staying, and then loved Orlando, Florida, and the product and the company so much. 25 years later, I said, wow, what a career. And I was very fortunate and lucky to have the opportunities that I did to live in Japan and China and California and do a lot of things for a really, really great company. I went on to become president of Four Seasons Hotels and Resorts. And so, you know, a little bit of experience in dealing with these themed experiential assets and creating media and guest experiences of high quality. And when I got the call to come here, I'm originally from Ohio and love football, love professional football, followed the Browns my whole life, good and bad, still do. And I thought, what an opportunity to have an impact not only on the game, but on a community that I have great passion for. So came back and you know, started to develop the plan and assemble the team. And, you know, for the last 2 years, I think we've had some good success, with the exception of the delays that coronavirus has created for all of us. And I'm pretty proud of the team. The board you know, when I helped assemble the board, it was really important for me to have the right level of expertise. And so we have board members that are, that have, you know, former CEO of Great Wolf Lodge, you know, destination-based assets. Another board member that was president of a cruise line, another board, couple of board members that were partners in big accounting firms. So we have a really, really professional board that helps us sort of navigate the ship and create and make sure the plan is being executed against and frankly holds us accountable too. Curtis Martin, Hall of Famer on our board, you know, educating us, you know, on ensuring that we're considering the Hall of Fame and the Hall of Famers, and because we're doing this, you know, for them and to give them a place and a community to live and come back to over and over. But beyond that, creating media and gaming and other opportunities for them to participate in and to continue to have a place in business. And so our board has a big part of that. The management team, as I said before, a really high quality, high energy group that loves football, loves sport, but more importantly, has the right expertise. You know, some working for publicly traded companies, some managing and leading sports franchises from basketball to women's tennis to other things, some in the leisure tourism business. And so, you know, we've put together, I'm pretty proud of the team that we've assembled that's really leading the charge here. And I keep saying it, but executing the game plan. And I think even in a really difficult environment, we're proving to have some success. And we're looking forward to this year. A lot of exciting things coming this year as well. So it is important, you know, Tyron talked about it. The team, both at an executive level and at a board level, really do give me a lot of comfort and a lot of support to take some chances and do the right things for our shareholders and for the community here as well.
So, Mike, real quick, take about 1 minute and give everybody a snapshot of what the future is going to look like for the Hall of Fame Resort and Entertainment Company.
Well, we build a destination here in Canton like any other, powered by professional football around the Pro Football Hall of Fame. It's a place that has phenomenal events and activities, great entertainment, attractions and rides for people to come and stay and play and enjoy, unique brands. We continue to build potentially those types of things, much smaller versions in other cities around the country. I love that growth for physical destinations because it extends our brand and allows people to engage in places where they live. We continue to create great stories. We're already doing that in our media division, but developing partnerships. We're a content company, building production and distribution partnerships that are looking for great content, great sport, football content. Never been a higher demand for that than there is today. And then lastly, you know, gaming. I like to grow fans through all different types of points of engagement. Esports, we really have to have a place for people to come and engage. We want to be a part of tournaments. We want to be a part of how potentially, you know, the best are celebrated, maybe even a Hall of Fame. And our fantasy league launches this year with Hall of Fantasy. And I think that's going to be a one of a kind experience. It's just going to knock the fantasy players' socks off. They're going to keep wanting to come back over and over, cheering for their teams. And then as sports betting is legalized, we start to integrate that as a part of the experience, the fan experience, that they can engage with the things that we're doing in a way that is meaningful for them. So lots of growth, lots of opportunity, and we're already planning and executing the next phase. So it's exciting.
Oh, that's wonderful. Good stuff, Mike. We want to welcome all those who are tuning in, CBS, NBC, Fox, all those Hotel TV. Welcome back. This is an exciting moment, exciting segment for the Sports Circus. We're here with Mike Crawford. Man, me and Mike become best buddies. Bunk buddies. He gonna have the top bunk. I'm right underneath. We're gonna be blessed with this show. But Mike, I got a question for you. Now, I'm going to quote somebody who I think is probably one of the best to ever play the game at defensive back. Now, this guy says that the Hall of Fame is watered down. Now, I'm talking about Deion Sanders. That's a quote that he said. He says, "What is the Hall of Fame now? Is it a guy who played a long time? It's so screwed up now. Once upon a time, a Hall of Famer was a player who changed the darn game. He made you want to reach into your pocket and pay your admission to see this guy play. That's not the Hall of Fame anymore. Every Tom, Dick, and Harry, you're a Hall of Famer. You're a Hall of Famer. You're a Hall of Famer. They let anybody in this thing. It's not exclusive anymore. So, Mike, my question, is that true? Is that a fair assessment by Dion? Is the Hall of Fame letting anybody in these days?
I want to address the one thing that you said. That was a guy who, for me, did change the game. And he was and still is an incredible guy. I enjoy watching him. I enjoy listening to him. He was a prolific athlete unlike any other. I really do have a lot of respect for Dion. Listen, we have just over 360, 370 Hall of Famers enshrined in Canton, Ohio. You know, over 50 plus years, I'm not sure I would consider that watering down the Hall of Fame. And that's not to take away from Dion's opinion. He's certainly entitled to that. But we have a highly qualified group of selectors that are very diligent about running the traps on whoever we enshrine, because we know our gold jackets, our Hall of Famers, this is a brotherhood. This is a club, an exclusive club unlike any other. And that's one of the things that attracted me about having the opportunity to build a company powered by and in partnership with the Pro Football Hall of Fame. We have a group. I mean, when we have enshrinement, you know, there's 160 plus living Hall of Famers, 120, 130 of them come back every single year. They take this very seriously, as do we. So while I love Dion and I respect him and everything he's accomplished, and certainly everybody's entitled to their opinion, I think I'd have a slightly different view when you look at the numbers and the selection process and who we have enshrined here. I think every one of them contributed at a high level to professional football, and that's what's allowed them to become and earn that title of Hall of Famer. And we're proud of that. We're proud to be able to have them here in Canton, Ohio.
Now, I got to throw this one in too. Now, baseball, they had Roger Clemens and a lot of guys like that who didn't make it. Now, Sal, I know you probably want to touch on that too. You know, I'm like, you know, baseball, I kind of like the way they do it. You get in, you get in.
Buddy, we don't have time for that. Look, I could do that one for a week straight. And believe me, a lot of people are just going to eventually just say,
shut up! Shut up!
Right? That's it. This is exactly what's going to happen. So I don't even want to get into that. But what I do want, we're running on time here. I want to give Mike Crawford, Chairman, President, CEO, Hall of Fame Resort and Entertainment Company, a chance to tell everybody how to follow them, more information, kind of wrap it up, put a nice bow tie in, and take a minute and do that for us, Mike, would you?
Absolutely. Thanks, Sal. Thanks, Tyrone. First of all, great to be here with you guys. I love what you do. I love this show. And I absolutely love what you said. It's real. It's authentic. And that's what we are. So, you know, for us, we're a publicly traded company on the NASDAQ under the ticker symbol HOFV, Hall of Fame Resort and Entertainment Company. You can find us there on our website as well. We have two different websites, one for the parent company, Hall of Fame Resort and Entertainment Company.com, and then Hall of Fame Village, powered by Johnson Controls, is the destination here in Canton, so hallofamevillage.com as well. We do a lot in social media. We want to make sure we're engaging with our fans and making sure we're transparent and letting them know, you know, with our investors as well, what we're doing. And we have a team that is really focused on getting the word out and creating awareness. It's important, you know, that people understand who we are and what we do. And being on your show today is a big help for that. So thank you very much.
Big round of applause. Tyrone, any final thoughts here for Mr. Crawford? What do you think?
No, I think the fans have been very educated and very excited about what you know, pro football is all about and what Mike is representing, and he's continuing to move the ball down the field, as we say, trickling the ball down the field, like the late great Hank Stram would say. So I love it. I like it. Hopefully one day I'll be up in the hall, and I'll be saying, I want to thank Mike Crawford. I want to thank Sal. I want to thank Sonar. I want to thank everybody. I want to thank everybody for watching the Sports Circus. So thank you, Sal, for giving me that opportunity. But Mike, thank you for being our guest. Thank you.
You're a Hall of Famer.
Yes, yes. Mike, thanks for joining us again. Folks, if you missed this, go back to thesportscircus.com. Click on any of the logos for Apple Podcasts or Spotify, iHeartRadio. They're all there. Go to today's date. Click on it. Listen to it in its entirety. For Mike Crawford, Chairman, President, CEO, Hall of Fame Resort and Entertainment Company, and two-time Super Bowl champion, American Ninja Warrior, Tyrone Poole, I'm your Ringmaster, Sal. We'll see you next time on your favorite station. Till then, so long, everyone.
Thanks, guys.
So, you want to be in show business. Do people tell you that you're really funny, you have a great personality, and you should have your own talk show? Many of us have been told that, but we don't know how to get started. It's easier than you think. Let the pros at Cali Vegas give you a free talent evaluation. Call 949-445-1119 and learn how quickly you can create, produce, and host your very own talk show. Imagine not having to sit in traffic every day, commuting back and forth to the same old boring job. Get started in television or radio today with your free talent evaluation from Cali Vegas. Call 949-445-1119 or visit them online at calivegas.com. Make your dream come true today and create your new career and learn how to become a television or radio star with the help of Cali Vegas. 949-445-1119. Call now.
Hello, health seekers. It's John Harrison.